Dear friends, welcome to another video. Today we continue the building of the weather station. In the last video we had implemented the temperature and humidity measurement using the DHT11 sensor. Today we add pressure measurement in our weather station as well with the BMP180 sensor. As you can see in the display, we now have temperature, humidity, and pressure in pascals. Let's compare those readings with one professional weather station. As you can see, temperature is almost the same. Humidity, we are off 4%, and pressure is exactly the same. As you can see, our little weather station is very accurate so far. Let's see how to connect the BMP180 sensor to our project. The sensor is very small, as you can see, it's almost 1 centimeter long and wide. This is the sensor here, and this is some passive components needed for driving the sensor. There are 4 pins in the display, in the sensor. The vein, ground, of course, for power, the SEL and SDA. This sensor, this breakout board, uses the I2C protocol, so we only need 4 pins in order to drive this sensor. I have soldered 4 header pins in order to be easy to connect it to our breadboard. So let's see how to connect it. I have already connected the DHT11 sensor. You can watch the previous video of this series to see how to connect it in your project. Now let's connect the BMP111 sensor. I press it down here so we can connect it. The first pin from the left is the VCC. So I get 5 volts from the breadboard here and connect it here. 5 volts goes in. The next pin is ground, so ground goes here. Now the third pin, I have to remove it to see. Third pin is SCL. SCL and then SDA. So SCL pin from Arduino goes to third pin here and the other to the SDA of the Arduino. That's very easy to connect, so let's power it up again and see if it is still working. Okay, perfect. Temperature 24, because we were touching the sensor, and humidity 55%, and pressure 1018 pascals. Now, this little sensor here has embedded a very accurate temperature sensor as well. So, we are not measuring temperature with the DHT11, which is not accurate. We are measuring temperature with this sensor, and we display it in the display. Let's see, if I press the sensor, you can see in 2 seconds the temperature will rise. See how accurate this is. So we are measuring temperature and pressure from this sensor and humidity from this sensor. All the data are displayed in a LCD screen. Now let's see the software side of the project. First of all, we have to download the BMP180 breakout library. You can download it from the link you can find in the description of the video below. When you enter this website, all you have to do is to press download zip from here. Now that the download has been done, has been completed, we have to unzip this file. In here we can see 3 folders and some other files. All you will have to do is to go to software, Arduino, libraries, unzip this folder here and rename it to something more easy. Okay, now we cut this folder and paste it in the Arduino libraries folder. Now we are ready to use it in our project. I have here a project named Weather Station. You can find the full code of the project in the description of the video, of course. Now, this is the complete code of the project so far. First of all, we have to include the BMP180 library. Then we create a pressure object of type BMP180. We declare a float temperature, which is a variable public and accessible from everywhere in the code. And then, this is important, we have to define altitude in order to have correct measurement of the barometric pressure. So here we enter the altitude of our location in meters. For me, in Sparta, Greece, it's 216 meters the altitude. The code here is the same as the previous video. The only thing we have to do here is to add pressure.begin to initialize the pressure sensor. Then I read humidity and add 10% in order to calibrate the reading of the sensor to my professional weather station. I have seen that my humidity sensor, the DHT11, is off about 10% all the time. So I manually add 10% to the reading in order to be closer to reality. Then I read pressure and temperature from the BMP sensor. Let's see what this function does. This is the code of the function. All it does, it reads temperature and saves it to the public variable temperature we had seen in the beginning. And then it reads pressure from the sensor and returns the value. So this function returns pressure, which is then saved in this variable, and sets this public variable temperature. Then I convert all those readings, temperature, humidity and pressure, to string variables, and I print them out. It's very easy. Download the code, use it and modify it to your own needs. Now that we have completed the first version of our weather station, let's see how much current it draws, the power consumption of this project. The power consumption, as you can see, is very high. It now draws 80, and at a few times you can see up to 90 milliamps. The power is 0.38 watts. So let's make some calculations. If I run this project from this power bank, which has a capacity of 2400 milliamp hours, this project will draw this power bank in just over one day. So what we'll do, what we will have to do if we want our project to run for months or for weeks, we cannot use this project. We have to find some ways to reduce power consumption, and we'll do that in the next videos. The first thing is to replace this power hungry screen, and of course put the Arduino in sleep when not needed to run. So in the next videos we will replace the screen of this project with this low power screen of a Nokia 5110 screen, which draws very little power, and then we'll see how we can put Arduino to sleep and see if we can make it draw less current. And the last thing, of course, is to sync our project to an Arduino Pro Mini in order to use the minimum power we can. So, all this stuff in the next videos. Thank you very much for watching. Please subscribe to our channel if you want to see our next videos, and press like if you like our projects. Bye!